Coming up, you'll meet Advocate Capital client Sam Adams. Hey Sam, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
I was checking the records today. You've been a client of ours since 2008. Wow, time has really flown.
It's gone by super fast for us too.
Well, we really appreciate you as a client. Thanks so much for being with us, but also for the work that you do for your clients there in Utah and throughout the country. It's important work. You're the keys of the courtroom. We appreciate that. I wanted to ask you today a couple questions about being an Advocate Capital client, if I may.
Sure.
So over the past, 10-ish years, how has being an Advocate Capital client impacted your law firm?
Well, it's impacted us greatly. When we first started out, I mean, it was actually vital that we had some credit lines and had access to, so we could, work on the cases we had. And as you know, some of these cases cost thousands and thousands of dollars, and just having that credit line there and not having to worry about, how we're going to pay for an expert or file suit or traveling expenses. It was a real peace of mind.
Absolutely. Yeah, so as a customer of our AdvoTrack case expense funding service, one of the reasons I know you're a client is you can pass the borrowing costs through to the cases. So sometimes when we speak to a potential new customer, they're concerned that their client will object to the pass-through of the borrowing costs. What's your experience been?
It rarely comes up for me, and when it does, we explain it to every client, and most clients have no problems with that. Because I tell my clients, I'm your lawyer, I'm not your bank. You know what I mean? So it's one of those things where I have this company that I work with in tandem. There's some interest charges, and they usually have no objection. If they do have an objection, I always ask them if they want to just go ahead and write a $10,000 check, and I can just draw the costs off that, and they're not interested in that.
Yeah, not usually, right?
No.
Well, other law firms have concerns that borrowing cost, is an additional cost, and the overall situation might impact the client negatively. What do you think?
It is an additional cost, but it's so nominal. And the reality is the interest costs that I end up paying on those cases, it's so nominal that the fact that Advocate maintains and monitors those costs and keeps track of them, I actually think the money and time I save and having Advocate manage that part of the cost for me, it is well worth the interest that I pay at the end on the case.
Yeah, makes sense.
I get way more of a benefit than paying a $400 interest charge.
Yeah. Well, lastly, if a prospective client was thinking about joining us and you were chatting with them, and they said, well, I don't need the money, what would you say?
Well, I can't imagine a law firm that's looking into retaining your services to say they don't need the money. I think what happens is a lot of times that financial decision, that decision of whether or not we're going to hire that expert, there's always something in the back of your mind. You're thinking, well, geez, I don't know if I want to expend that cost, because what you're really thinking about is that is your money. And I think sometimes having an Advocate, it kind of takes that personal kind of I would almost call it a selfish motive of whether or not I actually want to expense the risk. Where in my mind I can just say, well, geez, I'm just gonna do the right thing, spend the money, get that expert, shore up the case, and not worry about it. So I'm not thinking about me and my money.
Yeah.
I mean, technically it is mine, because if I eventually lose or, the case, I'd have to pay out back. But at the same time, I think it takes that motivation of worrying about me and putting it on Advocate.
Absolutely. Well, once again, Sam, thanks for joining us today, and thanks so much for being our customer.
Yeah, thank you.